website, personal guidance, walk-ins, appointments, so much information on the website. And we meet with students, we explain, we provide Q&A workshops, so we do want them to do it right.
Yeah.
But that's a demand employment. And this is understandable. Everyone wants to gain hands-on experience.
Of course, yeah.
And just...
You want to add it to your educational experience.
Educational experience to build your portfolio and also get your degree, like some worth of your degree.
Yeah.
You spend so much energy and money into it. And post-completion OPT, optional practical training, is a very popular thing.
Yeah.
But also, role has been restricted lately. So
yes, I know. Post-2016.
We explain, though. We never leave it unattended, any immigration updates. And so I think that's a good opportunity to convey the message.
Yes.
Read our emails.
Oh, yes. Please.
Please.
Please. So, please. International students, if you're listening, every Monday, Mira sends out emails about the weekly updates about what's happening and reminders about what you are supposed to do as an international student to maintain your status. If you're now joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandieka, and joining us today is the Director for International Students and Scholars here at Pace University. And we're chatting with her, and we're also playing some music from countries all over the world represented here at Pace. And now we're going to take a trip to India. So for our Indian students, this one is especially for you.
Share tere kangne de tarike dil mangne de mera ve dil chori kita zehn tera ban gaya ye share tere kangne de tarike dil mangne de mera ve dil chori kita zehn tera ban gaya ye saiyan teri har gal jhukiyan tere hath vich kis di angutiyan har thodi naal ve tu gal karda
If you're now joining us, you're listening to Music from India. Today's show, we feature music from all over the world, representing some of the countries represented here at Pace University. And our guest today is Mira, and she is the Director for International Students and Scholars here at Pace University. And we're just chatting about the opportunities and services offered by the International Students and Scholars Office. And if you're joining us, and if you're now joining us, wherever you are in this world and you're listening, I hope you are enjoying the music. I muted your mic, so if you want to cough, you can cough. I muted your mic. So if you want to cough, you can.
If I want to
cough.
Ah, cough. I muted your...
Yeah.
Yeah, I won't. Thank you.
You're okay? Continuing with the music on today's show for the international experience, we're playing something else from India. And I'm not going to even to attempt to say what this is, but I love it. I love Indian music. And if you grew up in Guyana, if you went to school with me, high school in Guyana, you know how much I loved listening to Indian music. And I would always watch all the Kuch Kuch Hota Hai and all of the latest Indian movies when they came out. So this one is really cool. I like this song. And I'm playing it especially for the international student population, India. They make up quite a bit. They're the largest student body, second largest student body here at Pace. So this one is for them. So, after this song, I'm going to ask you the last set of questions. What is the one service that your office offers that you wish more students would take? And anything else that you want to talk about?
Well, now, speaking of Indian population, mm-hmm. I can announce Diwali celebration.
Yes.
Diwali. I don't want to say it wrong. Diwali?
Diwali.
No. Yeah, I said it right.
Diwali.
So, yeah. And then you're going to ask me about the most important service?
Any service that you wish they would use more. Yeah. And anything else you want to add?
Okay.
Stacy, I wish I knew the words. I really wish I knew the words, Stacy, but I don't. So... next time I'm going to learn the words for next time so I can sing along. Good afternoon to everyone listening to the international student population here at Pace. If you're listening, remember every week we stream live at WPUB.org on Tuesdays from 12 to 1 p.m. And if you're an international student and you are interested in being featured on the show, you're interested in appearing on the show, or you would like to have your music played on the show, you can send me an email at tjohnson3@pace.edu. You can also follow me on Instagram at Tandieka. That's at TANDIEKA. And you can also come and find me on the fourth floor of the Lubin School of Business at One Pace Plaza. I'm easy to talk with and I love to chat. So seek me out and we can talk about your country and arrange for you to appear on the show. I have no idea what they're singing about. All I know it's from, I think, the movie War, but it's absolutely beautiful.
It's beautiful, it is.
And, I hope you enjoy that. And that came from India. And if you're now joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandieka, and I'm here every Tuesday from 12 to 1 p.m. talking about the international cultures and the international student population here at Pace University. And for today's show, I have our guest is the Director for International Students and Scholars here at Pace, Mira. And she's been a gracious guest. She was gracious enough to join us, and we're so happy that she came. And as we continue to chat with her, Mira, can you tell us, speaking of India, I believe that there is an upcoming event to celebrate Diwali. Can you tell us a little about that?
If you read my emails.
Which we know half of them don't. But we'll work on that. I'm gonna remind them every week to read your emails.
To read my emails. Not only my emails, my colleagues as well, international student advisors. It's a way of communication. It's many of you, international students, and we wish we can talk to each one of you in person, but it cannot happen, at least at this time, at this age we live in.
Mm-hmm.
So I communicated a couple of days ago, the event is going to happen on October 25th.
Mm-hmm.
At 7 p.m. at One Pace Plaza Student Center, but you need to purchase a ticket. I don't remember on top of my head. I believe it's just $5. It's very affordable.
Mm-hmm.
And there is a link in my mass email. You just click on it. You get that website. And don't forget there is a password in the same email. You need a password in order to buy a ticket with discounted price. We will send another reminder. Just read it. So it's going to be a huge event. It's going to be an interesting event.
Mm-hmm.
Don't miss it. And there will be refreshments, Indian food. I personally love Indian food.
Oh, so do I.
So do you.
Especially the sweets.
I know. I don't,
there's this one sense, we do in Guyana called Penus. Oh, so good.
I like that vegetarian food.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm a vegetarian. So I like that selection of vegetarian mm-hmm. foods.
And the samosas. Those are usually good.
Mm-hmm. Samosas, yeah. So, yeah, and we will have samosas, I believe. I'm not sure. I'm not the program coordinator. someone else, but she's good. I'm sure she has good menu.
Yeah.
So not only Indian students, everyone is welcome.
Yes.
And the music was beautiful, by the way.
Yes.
I loved that song.
I love that song, too.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad that you talked about the event. I did go to that event last year. It was outside in the courtyard in One Pace Plaza, I believe.
Wasn't it the Color War?
Was that the Color War? Maybe.
I think
that was for Pagua. That might have been for Pagua. But it was fun. Anyway,
yeah.
it was something for to celebrate one of the Indian holidays. The food was delicious.
That was Indian food, yeah.
And I really like whenever we have these type of activities because it kind of reminds me of home. In Guyana, we have 6 races, and one of the races represented is Indians. And so I really enjoy eating Indian food. So whenever there's, these kind of activities, I really look forward to it. So I encourage you, international students, if you're listening, and if you're reading Mira's emails, to please sign up to go to this event. When is the event again? Remind them the date.
Friday, October 25th.
Mm-hmm. That's next Friday.
Next Friday. But mm-hmm. also tickets will go away fast. So
yeah.
It's going to be by ticket only. It's admission. So strictly.
Okay.
Then they need to hurry up. Yeah.
Okay.
Tell
me, before you go, what is the one service that you wish international students would utilize more that your office offers?
Well, first of all, when we plan and when we very well prepared to provide immigration workshops,
mm-hmm.
and it's very well planned, we don't want to see empty seats.
Yes.
And we book big spaces like lecture hall.
Yeah.
And when we see empty seats, we just wondering, didn't you ask us about employment? Didn't you, international students, if you're listening to me, please attend. or talk to us. If you think the time is not good for your schedule, doesn't work, mm-hmm. talk to us, suggest another time. So we really work hard. We want everyone to know, is and again, about benefits and restrictions. And you did ask for those workshops. You want to know more. But when you don't come, and then you're just sending us endless emails about all the same we covered in the workshop, we are wondering what's happening.
Yeah.
So this is one. My second message is do not leave anything, especially time-sensitive items, until the very last minute. Travel signature request has to be done at least 3 days in advance.
Mm-hmm.
We've been having students just coming on the date of a flight or coming 1 hour before flight.
Yeah.
So try to do things on time. We are serving big population requesting very same items, travel signatures. It's a wishful thinking, and I know everyone is busy. I'm not here to criticize or to judge. I'm
just encourage. Yeah,
encouraging, and just I wish you would come on time to request travel signature. And it always happens in December when students are saying, what do you want from me? I had my finals to take or my exams. So I just finished, and I know you will be closed tomorrow, so I need my travel signature today. So my wishful thinking, just do things ahead of the time, please.
Be proactive.
Be proactive. Use our services as much as you can get worth of it. Yes. So we try our best to support you, but we also need
your support.
Your support, exactly. Yeah. And we know that we've done a good job.
Yes.
And my last message is use resources, because our website is so user-friendly. We work hard on it with expanded chapters, information. Read it. And, of course, we are your better resource than a website. But before you ask a question, I think it would be a really good idea to read about all the same on the website.
Yes.
Use our walk-ins. We provide extended hours twice a week now.
Yes.
It's new for this semester.
Mm-hmm.
Mondays 2 to 6, drop-by hours, walk-ins, no appointment is needed. Wednesday is the same, 2 to 6. Oh, you just got me tired with your questions. 2 to 6.
Well, it's a good thing. It's a good thing.
That's, I now sound like a broken record.
It's a good thing.
2 to 6, 2 to 6. Come see us. Don't be stranger. We're reachable, approachable. Just ask for help. Okay. One last thing, one last resource. It's an International Student Navigator, a relatively new website. We worked really hard on it. It's very easy to access pace.edu/international-student-navigator.
Mm-hmm.
That is a one-stop shop for everything. University services, how to pay your bill. OSA is in agreement. They're not going to be upset if you check our website for that, because we redirect you to the right pages. Also about visa, about do's and don'ts, but on top of it, university services, how to check your academic schedule, how to activate your student portal, banner.
Yes.
You will be redirect. You will know everything. It's that is why it's called International Student Navigator, kind of one-stop shop. Use it. Use the resources.
And those are the final words from Mira for today. Use the resources that are available to you, international students. I encourage you to do so. And speaking of the International Students and Scholars Office, we want to thank Mira for coming on the show today to talk about the services that are offered and the opportunities available to international students. And just a reminder to international students, every Thursday is tea and coffee from 3:25 to 4:25 at 163 William Street on the 16th floor. Mira spoke also about the Diwali celebration that's on the 25th of October. Purchase your tickets. You guys would have received an email on Monday about that. So
Halloween celebration.
The Halloween celebration, yes. So this is the Taiwanese Association, Sabor Latina, Urban Sound, and Hatha, along with the International Student Club. They're having the Fright Night Party. So come in your costume. It's on the 31st of October at the Student Center. I encourage you to participate and get involved in as many activities as you can. If you're now joining us, you're listening to the International Experience. I am Tandieka, and we're here every Tuesday from 12 to 1 p.m. And today we're featuring music from all over the world. And we're going to go to Austria now. And this one, thank you, Rebecca, for this one.
I'm running because I had some things to see.
I also wanted to say thank you to you, like, officially, but you didn't give me a chance.
You want to what?
To say thank you to you. Thank you for doing that.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
That show, and I didn't know that you were going to play. And thank you for having me, but bigger thank you for just doing that show.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for coming on the show. Yes, I'm going to unmute your mic so I can do that. So you can do that.
Tandieka, I want to express my sincere appreciation for starting that show. I think it's extremely important to show to international students that they matter to the university. It's kind of a showcase to have on campus, to show international presence, supporting the entire university mission is inclusion and equality.
Yes.
So basically to show the international student case is to support the university mission. So I think you're doing great things, and thank you for having me today. And just I hope we will meet again at the show. Oh, in my office.
Yes, I'm sure I'm going to have to come for a travel signature sometime.
Okay.
Thank you so much, Mira, for coming on the show.
Thank you.
If you're now joining us, you're listening to some music from Austria, and this one I got from Rebecca. So thank you, Rebecca, for sharing this one with me. It's called Running on Air. And for the next couple of minutes, we're going to be talking with Tamara Kelly. She's a dear friend to the show, and she's a director for communications and external relations in the Leuven School of Business. She's my boss. I'm her grad assistant, and Tamara is coming to talk about the EIR activity that we have coming up this week. So every semester, we host an executive in residence, And actually, we just had one executive in residence event on the Pleasantville campus on Monday, and that executive in residence was Kevin Boland. And we want to encourage students to come out to these events. I'll tell you why. As a student, I've been going to these events since I have joined the Leuven office as a grad assistant. And I find these events to be very, very helpful to you as a student, because you get to chat with these C-suite executives about their experience as a student and how they've evolved to the success that they have today. And so I encourage you to listen to Tamara, and she will talk about the EIR that's coming up this Thursday. So after this music break, we will be joined by the beautiful Tamara Kelly.
Thank you.
Take one ear off so that you can hear. Yeah.
Oh.
That's what I, yeah, that's good.
Take one ear off.
Do you want to be seen on camera? She didn't want to.
Oh, no, that's okay. What time is it?
Huh?
What time is it, Tandieka?
It's 12:50.
Oh, gosh. Okay. I'll meet
you in
time.
Mm-hmm. We're going to, after this song ends.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And this one is from China, and I got this one from Xi. So thank you so much for sharing this one with me, Xi. I don't know what he's saying, but this is Chris Wu from China. Good afternoon to everyone listening via online at WPUB.org, and good afternoon to everyone joining us from Facebook and those who were joining us on Instagram. I'm sorry I had to end the live feed. The connection was really bad. So we're now on Facebook Live. Hello to you, Stacy, Stacy and Stacia, and Melissa and Jillian. Thank you all for watching. You can keep it on. I just told you if it's too loud for you.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
If you're now joining us now, we're chatting with Tamara Kelly. So, Tamara, tell us about the upcoming EIR, what it is, and who is the executive in residence this Thursday.
Okay, well, thank you very much, Tandieka, for inviting me on your show. I'm just so proud of her. She's a graduate assistant. She works in our office, and she told me about this great idea that she had, so I think it's fantastic that her dream has now come to fruition. So with that being said, Tandieka, thank you for plugging the Executive in Residence program. So the Executive in Residence program has been in existence for over 30 years at the Lubin School of Business. Typically what we do is we invite C-suite executives to campus to talk about their careers and how they ascended the corporate ladder. Some of those individuals are also entrepreneurs. So that brings me to the executive that will be our executive in residence on Thursday. Her name is Desiree Reed, and she is actually a Lubin alumna. Desiree is the founder and president of Desiree Reed and Company. She's worked for a number of companies. Actually, her focus, she's very passionate about marketing and branding. She's also been featured in Allure and Essence magazines. They have said that she is a business industry insider to watch. So we're definitely looking forward to her visit to campus. So I encourage all of you out there listening to come and to hear Desiree speak. She will, Dean Braun actually, will be interviewing her on Thursday in Schimmel Theater from 2 to 3 p.m. So I hope that you will all come, and we have so many great executives, that come to campus. And, you know, we're always asking because we want to ensure that students have an opportunity to connect with business leaders. You know, you could go to a number of other schools and you may not necessarily have an opportunity to meet a business leader one-on-one. But through this program, you're able to, and we have such great people coming. We have all industries represented. As you know, Desiree is into marketing, but we just had Kevin Boland, as Tandieka stated. He represents one of the big four firms, KPMG, and we've had people from almost any industry you can think of to come to campus. And who knows, maybe one day it will be you.
Yes,
so
one day.
Definitely, that's right, So I do hope that you will join us on Thursday, October 17th at 2 p.m. Dean Braun will be interviewing Desiree Reed. To reserve a space at the event, please visit EIR RSV. And again, Tandieka, thank you for this great opportunity.
Thank you for joining us, Tamara. And just to encourage you again, students, please sign up for the Executive in Residence this Thursday and just come out. Trust me, there's a lot that you can learn from these executives that come to share their experience with us. If you are now joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandieka. And today we featured music from all over the world. And I don't want to get this one. No. Hey! You know what I like about music from all over the world? It doesn't matter what they're saying. As long as there's a beat that we can all dance to and dance together and celebrate as one, then we're good. So I don't know what he's saying, but I think it's a beautiful song. It's a nice beat, a nice rhythm. And that's how we should be as international people. Our guest today, the Director of International Students and Scholars, Mira, talked about her being a global citizen. And that's how we should aspire to be global citizens, so we can have an understanding of each other's cultures and each other's perspective. So if you're now joining us, you're listening to The International Experience. I'm your host, Tandieka, and we're on every Tuesday from 12 to 1 p.m., streaming live at WQB.org. And you can join us if you're an international student and you're interested in appearing on the show or having music from your country featured on the show. Please reach out to me at tjohnson3@pace.edu. And you can also follow me on Instagram at Tandieka. Slide into the DMs only to talk about coming on the show. And of course, just bring your music list with you and we're going to have a fun dance party while we talk about your culture, okay? I can't go off the show today again without taking you back to the Caribbean. So I really love this one. I love this band. So here is Kez performing Savannah Grass. Tuesday morning,
everybody coming in. We ready to burn. We gon' make them up.
We gon' make them free up.
We gon' make them white. We gon' make them free up. It's this place of bacchanal. In this big botanical, this carnival. I want you to find your way.
Ponte to la doy.
If you're coming down from the mountain.
Oh, la doy. The Savannah grass,
you could see it so many cuts, red or light. When the people tell you they can't have red or light, we need to be jumping in tongues. We come around
the Savannah grass.
So I'm going to leave you today with Kaz and the Savannah Grass, and I hope that you enjoyed the show today. And I hope that you join us again next week, Tuesday, same time, same place, 12 to 1 p.m. at WPUB.org, broadcasting live here from Pace University at WPUB Radio in downtown New York. I'm going to be sharing this show on my Facebook, so if you missed it, you know, you could always catch it there. But again, check us out next week, Tuesday, same time, same place. I thank you for listening and watching. Have a great day.